Andrew Latto is a senior analyst at Fat Profits and joins us now to take a look at the power sector and nuclear in particular. Andrew, investors in energy stocks are banking on a strong demand in the coming decades, but have the recent events in Japan changed the dynamic at all?
Well, clearly we are going to see strong demand no matter what the energy mix turns out to be. Some forecasts are for demand to increase by about 80% over the next 30 years. Principally due to non-OECD countries, China and India. But how countries meet that challenge remains to be seen. As you point out, the situation in Japan is clearly making a number of countries more nervous about nuclear power. However, we believe that because of the disadvantages of the other energy sources, nuclear power is still likely to see growth. The disadvantage of fossil fuels are that it means more carbon emissions, and it makes countries dependent on imports. The disadvantage of renewable energy is that it can be unreliable and very costly. So nuclear power will play an important part in that mix and is likely to grow.
If you ask the people of Fukushima what they think, it will obviously be very different from people in other areas where there's not likely to be a nuclear plant, but how safe are these nuclear plants now? How much more safe are they than even just 20 years ago, which is when our last one here in Britain was commissioned?
Well, absolutely that's a concern for many countries. The Fukushima plant itself was over 40 years old, and we've seen that a number of safety failures, such as, for example, backup power supply. And we think that going forward, the plants will be much safer. A good example is that you can have passive cooling systems as opposed to cooling systems powered by diesel generators. And secondly, there's even talk of other types of fuel that would be much safer than uranium, such as thorium. Very practical measures that the Japanese industry is introducing are to have fire engines on sites, to have emergency power lines to the plant at all times. So we think these measures will be effective and that they will allow the nuclear power industry to become much safer than it has been.
So how does an investor go about playing this market then? Let's start off with the metal itself, uranium.
Uranium has had a very strong run from the middle of 2010. The price was $40 a pound. At the start of this year, it was around $70 a pound. And of course, on the events in Japan, has sold off quite strongly to around $60, but has still held up. It's important to note that not all the demand for uranium is met by current mine output. So a key part of the demand is met by stockpiles being exhausted. And therefore, we think that even in light of the events in Japan, the uranium price is going to remain strong. And this is a very key boost for the uranium miners and will remain so for the coming decades.
Talk about the miners themselves. What stocks could investors look at if they're looking at a long-term investment in nuclear?
In London, there isn't a huge array of stocks. We do have Kalahari Minerals.
Listed in London?
Yep, that's right. And we do have Berkeley Resources. Mm-hmm. Kalahari has received a takeover bid from a Chinese company for over £700 million. And Berkeley Resources is much smaller at about £80 million. Berkeley Resources is in Spain and has got quite an interesting project there, which is moving towards commercialization. Kalahari has a stake in the Husab project in Namibia, which potentially could be one of the world's largest uranium mines, possibly even the top three. So these are two UK listed companies that are potentially the way UK investors could play the sector.
What about the overseas opportunities?
Well, one of the largest pure uranium miners is Cameco. This is a group that has increasingly sought to focus on uranium, for instance, selling its gold assets. And this is a company which is principally in quite stable countries such as Canada and Australia. The company is looking to boost uranium output by as much as 75% towards 2018. And that would mean output of around £40 million per year. And so that's quite an interesting company to look at. It's also a company that has very long-term contracts, so it's reasonably hedged in terms of if uranium prices fell significantly. Rio Tinto is, of course, well known to London investors, and that's one of the top three uranium producers.
Of course, I mean, that's got so many other interests, isn't it? So I don't know how big a part of uranium is on that, but that's another interesting play for uranium, though, is it?
It's one of the most of the diversified plays, such as BHP, Xstrata, and Rio Tinto. It's the one that has perhaps the most significant uranium exposure, but absolutely you're right. It also has other energy interests, such as coal, and is across the whole array of commodities. Its principal earnings generators are copper and iron ore. So you would only be buying uranium exposure as part of a very diversified mix.
Okay, Andrew, thanks for joining us. So it's Andrew Latto, the senior analyst here at Fat Profits.
This film is for educational and leisure purposes only. Proactive Investors does not provide investment advice. The company is a publisher and is not registered with or authorized by the Financial Services Authority. Please refer to the full terms and conditions on the Proactive Investors website.